Morning everyone, welcome to the garage. Today I will continue my work on the open inverter board. So hopefully I will connect the board and I will enable the PWM signal. So this signal will drive IGBT transistors on the inverter and eventually will drive the motor. Today my plan is to connect the board, plug it in, power it up and test programming firmware through the Wi-Fi connection. To start the inverter, I will need to connect, as well as 12 volt supply, I will need to connect MG forward in pin to the 12 volts as well, and I will start the inverter in the manual mode. Here I am connecting pin 3, which is MG forward in signal. I am using the test link wires just to connect pin 1 and pin 3 together and to connect them to 12 volts. Now I'm connecting DC to DC converter connections as well as the 50 pin JST connector and current sensors and temperature sensors. So I'm mounting the rear support frame for the temperature sensor wires and current sensor wires. Now all I need to do is just to secure the frame with a couple of bolts at the back, at the sides of the frame. I use current limited power supply. First, I tested the power with the current limited to 200 milliamps to ensure that there's nothing is short-circuited in the board and not drawing too much current. Now I can connect both pins together and actually enable the power from the power supply to be delivered to the PCB. And we can see now that LED is on and flashing. And now I want to test the firmware update through the Wi-Fi. So basically it will update the firmware through the serial port. I'm connecting to the ESP module first, following by opening Chrome browser and typing IP address for the Hubner management console. So once we connect it and console is up and running, we can choose the update option to update firmware. So in this case, I'm gonna use Sine firmware because before I've uploaded FOC firmware. And I want to start the experiment from just using a simple Sine firmware in this case. So I've selected a bin file and chose to upload the file. And now we can see the progress of upload. And you can see that green LED is flashing on the Wi-Fi module, which means that the data has been transferred. And once the red LED on the board is flashing, then it means the firmware is ready. Okay, now the exciting bit. I'm going to measure the PWM on the inverter there. Okay, let's have a look. Okay, just pick up the ground from here. And now we started the inverter. So this is channel 1. That is quite strange. I'm not getting PWM signals. Crikey. Have a look at that. Right, I'm getting some strange interference. Let's just check the power line. Ooh, same thing on the 3 volts. What's going on? It looks like maybe I have some sort of a fault on the board. Can't believe this. I measured the voltages, they were all okay. What the hell is going on? Well, I'm not sure. I think I may have to try another board. Right, I'm back again. I could not believe it. I've just spent half an hour just trying to troubleshoot this issue. And actually it's turned out to be the damn probe again. So basically I found that I tried another board and it has the same problem. I found, it's actually I tried the different probe I had and I found it was a problem with this probe. So that what gave me that signal. It actually was not on the board at all. So let's see what I can measure now with a decent oscilloscope probe that I had, and just gonna use this one now. I could not believe it. I thought it was a problem with the power supply. Maybe it was just going into some sort of oscillation mode. Turned out to be I've just replaced the cable. And here we go. I'm just measuring. This is our PWM signal. I just need to synchronize it. Here we go. Beautiful. Just stay there. And measure another channel. Right, let me see if I can stop the inverter. Yep, I stopped the inverter and you can see that PWM signal is gone now. Again, start the inverter in manual mode and we have our signal back. Excellent, I'm very pleased. I'm finally actually getting some signal because I was already thinking that I had to maybe just start resoldering the board. And now it's all working. Fantastic. Okay, I now achieved another little milestone in my electric car journey. So I got a PWM signal working and I managed to update the firmware over the air. Next step will be to get the Toyota Prius gearbox, which I will use as a motor, and actually get be able to spin it first time. To do this, also I'm planning to procure some contactors, and actually I found quite interesting a debacle that I could see that I could purchase the Toyota Prius gearbox, which is effectively my motor, for about £100, which is probably around about $130. But at the same time, one contactor would probably be around about £60 to £50, so which is like $70. And effectively two contactors will be more expensive than the actual motor I'm getting. But anyway, I'm planning to look on eBay and see what I can find there. And yeah, basically the major step forward would be to actually achieving a spin of the electric motor. So it's a bit scary, but you know, I'm planning to move forward and trying to get it done. At the same time, the other things I need to consider is how to power the inverter, so getting the power supply, and possibly I'm looking at using a battery, lithium-ion battery. I'm recovering some batteries from laptop used batteries and planning to make modules so I can test the first time I can test the motor spinning. I'm not looking for very high voltage. I'm looking for about 60 to 70 volts, possibly maybe 80 volts. So that will be my next step. So thank you for watching. So if you are interested, please comment, subscribe, and if you want to see my future videos. Thank you.